Hello all, this is a second video of the two-part video series on juvenile idiopathic arthritis or JIA, in which I will be discussing the various treatment options of JIA. Like all other autoimmune diseases, JIA also has got two phases. The first phase of active disease where the child is symptomatic, and the second phase of remission where the child is symptom free. The aim of the treatment is to achieve the remission phase as early as possible and to prolong it for as long as possible. This can be achieved by using medications like non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs and disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs. Nowadays, with latest advances in the field of JIA, there are certain biologicals available in the market which have got high remission rate and lesser side effect. Besides medicines, exercises play a very important part in treatment of JIA. Exercises like cycling and swimming help a lot in building muscles around the joint. We also advise muscle strengthening exercises of the muscles around the joint depending on the joint involved. Sometimes the child develop contracture of the joint wherein the child is not able to fully straighten or bend the joint. In those cases, we advise stretching exercises of the joint. If the contracture does not improve, then we give splints or Botox injections. Sometimes a local steroid injection into the joint helps a lot. In cases where JIA involves the growing at end of the long bones in the lower limb, this leads to growth disturbances leading to unequal leg length on both the sides. These cases have to be managed surgically by doing epiphysiodesis. Sometimes the child develop joint deformities which are very severe and painful. In those cases, the child can be treated surgically by doing osteotomies or arthrodesis depending on the type of joint involved. So the take home message of this video is to diagnose the JIA as early as possible and treat it as aggressively as possible. We hit the JIA hard before it hits the patient. Also, mental support from parents and teachers help a lot in coping the symptoms. I hope I am able to give you a good insight into the juvenile idiopathic arthritis. Thank you and have a nice day.